Myself Ravindra Chavan, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So in this session, we will going to discuss how the timer 1 in PIC16F877 microcontroller operates and how it can be used for the different applications. Outcome from this session. At the end of this session, student can demonstrate the operation of timer 1 in PIC16F877 microcontroller. Student can also implement the timer 1 functionality in different applications. Outline of this session. The first part, the special function registers which are associating with the timer 1 operation, then how the timer 1 operates, and lastly the how timer 1 can be configured for the different modes of operation. In PIC16F877 there are three timers called the timer 0, timer 1 and timer 2. The timer 0 is the 8-bit and it can be used as a timer or as a counter. Timer 1 is of 16-bit and it also can be used as a timer or as a counter, while timer 2 is 8-bit and only we can operate in the timer mode. The major features of the timer 1 in PIC16F877 are, it is the 16-bit timer and counter, means the timer registers are of 16-bit and this value will increment from its initial count and goes up to its maximum value, that is FFFF, and from that it rolls over to the 00. Timer 1 can be used as a timer or as a counter. Timer mode is to be used to get the required time delay, and timer 1 has to operate in the counter mode when there is a need to count some external events. So timer 1 can operate on internal clock or on external clock. The timer registers we can read and also we can write. That's why the timer registers we are saying as a readable and writable. Also the timer 1 is having prescaler at the input clock. This prescaler mainly it is used to change the frequency of the clock, and prescaler can be used to get the more amount of delay by keeping the same clock frequency and same initial count. The timer 1 can also operate on internal clock or external clock. Interrupt on overflow from FFFF to 000 means when timer registers value is changing from its maximum, that is the FFFF to 000, timer 1 interrupt is occurred. The special function registers associating with the timer 1. The timer 1 module is a 16-bit timer slash counter which consists of two 8-bit registers, namely TMR1H and TMR1L, means timer 1 higher byte and timer 1 lower byte. And these two registers are readable and writable. And the TMR1 register is formed by the 8-bit registers TMR1H and TMR1L. And this timer 1 registers increments from its initial count, it may be a 000 or the required count, to FFFF and rolls over to 000H, and timer interrupt will be occurred. T1 con register that is the timer 1 control register, is to be used to control the operation of timer 1. This is the specified bit format of the timer 1 control register. The higher two bits, MSB bits, are not defined for any functionality. The next two higher bits, which are called the input clock prescale select bits, means these are associating with the prescaler, which will decide the prescale rate, or accordingly the frequency of the input clock will be changed. Now when the two bits, that is the timer 1 clock prescaler 1 and prescaler 0, when these two bits are 0, 0, the prescale value will be 1:1, means whatever the input clock to the prescaler, that will be remain same. When these two bits are 0, 1, then the prescale value will be 1:2, means whatever the input clock, that will be gates divided by 2, and so on. For 1, 0, the prescale value is 1:4, and for 1, 1, it is 1:8. Then the next bit is called the timer 1 oscillator enable control bit. So this timer 1 is having its own internal oscillator, which can be enabled or disabled as per the requirement. So when this timer oscillator enable bit is 1, the oscillator will be enabled, and to disable the internal oscillator, then timer 1 oscillator enable bit should be reset. Then the next bit is timer 1 synchronization bit. So this bit can be used to synchronize the external clock input. So this bit is having the meaning when we are selecting the external clock for the timer 1. So when this T1 sync bit is 1, the do not synchronize the external clock input means the timer 1 will operate on unsynchronized clock, and when 0, we will get the synchronized external clock. Now timer 1 clock source select bit is to be used to select either external clock or internal clock. Now external clock should be selected when we are going to operate the timer 1 in counter mode, and when there is need to operate in the timer mode, the timer 1 CS bit must be 0. So when timer 1 CS is set, the timer will be operate on external clock applied on port C pin RC0. And in timer mode, to select the internal clock, timer 1 CS bit must be reset. Now to turn on and off, the one bit is provided, that is called the timer 1 on bit. So when this timer 1 on bit is 1, the timer will be enable or it will be run. And to stop the timer 1, reset the timer 1 on bit. Now how the timer 1 operates? So timer 1 is increment either on every instruction cycle or on external clock applied at RC0/timer1 clock input pin. Now you pause the video and think how to select timer or counter mode of timer 1. Now to select the timer or counter mode, use timer 1 clock select bit from timer 1 control register. Now for the timer mode, make timer 1 CS equal to 0, and to operate in the counter mode, you set the bit timer 1 CS, and the timer 1 will operate on external clock. This is the working block diagram of the timer 1. So here the timer 1 oscillator is shown, which accepts the external clock applied on the pin RC0. Now this oscillator can be turned on or off by making the bit timer 1 oscillator enable. If oscillator will be enabled, then the oscillator output will be goes to the this first multiplexer. Now this first multiplexer is used to select either the internal clock, that is the oscillator frequency divided by 4, or the external clock applied on RC0 pin. And this multiplexer is controlled by the bit timer 1 CS. If timer 1 CS is 0, internal clock will goes to the prescaler, or if it is 1, then external clock will go to the prescaler. Now this prescaler can be operate on the clock prescaler bits, and the rate is really decided by the value of these two bits. Then here we are getting the synchronized and unsynchronized clock, and one of this will be get selected by making the timer 1 sync bit. And when timer 1 is on, then on each clock cycle this timer 1 register will increment, and when it rolls over, the timer 1 interrupt flag will be set. Now for setup of timer 1, first select the timer or counter mode, then use the prescaler bits to select prescaler rate, then put the initial count in timer register, turn on the timer 1 by making the use of timer 1 on bit, then the timer register will increment and rolls over from FF to 00, and timer 1 interrupt flag will set. The references used for this, the PIC data sheet and microcontrollers by Ajay Deshmukh. Thank you.